invite all of the children to please come down to talk with Church Mouse for a few minutes. Hi, Olin. Does anybody know who this is? That happens to be Cameron, and you know, Cameron is my little girl. You know, she used to be smaller than Ollie. She really did. And smaller than you, too. And Church Mouse is very, very excited that Cameron is home from college. She's a big girl in college now, and Church Mouse is so excited she's home, so she asked Cameron if she would read a book to you this evening. Would that be okay? Can you listen to a book that Church Mouse wants you to hear tonight? Great.
For all the world. Almost 2,000 years ago, Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the land of And Mary, his mother, wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. God chose Mary, a young Jewish woman, to be the one through whom all nations would be blessed. God might have chosen someone from a different land and from a different time. Jesus might have been born in Sapporo, Japan. Or on the Alaskan tundra. Or in Lithuania. Mary and her child might have looked like this, or this. Or this. Or this. Because God loves all the peoples of the world, and children. Like a true song named God. Yuri and Jill. But in that long ago time, God chose Mary and the little town of Bethlehem in the Judean hills. And there, in Bethlehem, God gave us Jesus. A gift of love for all the world.
Thank you, Cameron. Now I wonder if you think a minute what you might think Jesus looks like. Now Jesus might have had blonde hair and blue eyes and really light skin. Jesus probably had darker hair, darker eyes, and darker skin. And Jesus might have had really dark hair and really dark eyes and really dark skin. Jesus could look like anyone because God loves everybody and God loves all children. Now, Church Mouse has something she wants to ask you to think about as the rest of the service goes on. Think about what you think Jesus looks like, okay? Now, Church Mouse, right after the service, is going to go to bed. Because she thinks some wonderful, magical things are going to happen tonight, and she wants to be sure to be asleep so they can happen. And she encourages strangers, would you do the same? But I'm gonna cover Churc Mouse's ears for a minute. I would like you to give Churc Mouse a present tonight. Would you do that? When you leave, we're going to give you crayons and a piece of paper. Would you please draw a picture of Jesus, what you think baby Jesus looked like? And then when you go in for the cookies in the Great Hall later, there's a place where Churc Mouse will be sleeping. You'll see it. It says, shh, Churc Mouse sleeping. And there's a basket beside there. Would you please put your picture in the basket for Churc Mouse as your Christmas gift to Churc Mouse tonight? And ask Mom and Dad if you need some help to put your name on the picture if you would, okay? Okay, I'm uncovering Churc Mouse's ears, and she's saying to you, Merry Christmas. You say Merry Christmas to Churc Mouse? Thank you. Now, Cameron and I will help you get the paper and the crayons, okay? So everyone can take some paper. Ava, can you help me pass out some and make sure everybody gets some? Can you help me pass out paper and make sure everyone gets some? If you would all help Churc Mouse have that special present. Anybody need some more paper? Everybody have some? Okay, thank you so much. And you can go back and sit with your parents and be working on those special pictures.